Now I give the floor to the distinguished representative of the Democratic People's Republic of Korea.
Mr. President, today the situation of the Ukraine is now focusing the attention of the international community. The self-determination is a legal right of the people to decide their own destiny and international relation. Also, the self-determination is a legitimate right to freely choose their sovereignty and international political status without interference from others is a basic principle stipulated in UN Charter and the other international law. The residents in People's Republic of Donetsk, People's Republic of Luhansk, and the regions of the Kherson and Zaporozhye have the due right to freely determine and choose their sovereignty and international political status at their own discretion. The people in those regions have exercised their due right through referenda, the hold from 23 to 27 September 2022. We recognize that referenda were conducted in accordance with the UN Charter and international law, which stipulate principles of the equal rights and self-determination of people. Therefore, we respect the will of the people in People's Republic of the Donetsk, People's Republic of the Luhansk, and the regions of the Kherson and Zaporozhye, who aspire to integration into the Russian Federation and support the position of the government of the Russian Federation of the making of said regions component of the Russian Federation. We strongly insist that principle of self-determination enshrined the UN Charter international law must not apply in selective and partial manner. Mr. President, we clearly remember that sovereignty and territorial integrity of the former Yugoslavia, Afghanistan, Iraq, and Libya were violated brutally by United States and Western countries under the pretext of international peace and security. But unlawful and illegal acts of the Western country have never been called into question in UN Security Council. It is absurd for Western countries that they have given state, sovereign state in the past, are talking about respect for sovereignty and territorial integrity of the Ukraine, of the referenda held in People's Republic of the Donetsk and Luhansk, and the regions of the Kherson and Zaporozhye. Even today, United States interfere in internal affairs of sovereign state and infringe upon their legal rights by abusing UN Security Council in order to maintain hegemonic unipolar world. This is the same old trick of the United States, and the world is witnessing a lot of the similar illegal acts, not only in 20th century, but also 21st century. High-handedness and arbitrary practice and the partial and double standard acts can never be tolerated in any case. In conclusion, we strongly believe that the result of the referenda took place in People's Republic of Donetsk and the Luhansk and the regions of the Kherson and Zaporozhye must be respected in accordance with the basic principle of self-determination and non-interference in internal affairs of others. Also, the position of any sovereign state must be respected on this floor. But one previous speaker just before mentioned the position of the DPRK. His remark is mostly politically motivated remark. Of course, I can fully understand that he can say that because his country is not a sovereign state, I think.
I thank the distinguished representative of the Democratic People's Republic of Korea.